Bono, I understand you have new information on what this U.S. Embassy official has been saying under oath to these committee members.
Yeah, and I actually have obtained the opening statement from this aide of Bill Taylor, the top diplomat in Ukraine. The aide, David Holmes, delivering this statement, a 10-page, very detailed opening statement discussing exactly what has come out this week. He overheard a phone call between President Trump and Gordon Sondland, the ambassador to the European Union, in which the president was calling for investigations into his political rival, Joe Biden, wanting Ukraine specifically to launch the investigation. So I'm going to read from you a portion of this opening statement that details the lunch that Gordon Sondland had with President Trump, in which the president was calling for these investigations. So it says this. During the lunch, Ambassador Sondland said that he was going to call President Trump to give him an update. Ambassador Sondland placed a call on his mobile phone, and I heard him announce himself several times along the lines of Gordon Sondland holding for the president. It appeared that he was being transferred through several layers of switchboards and assistants. I noticed that Ambassador Sondland's demeanor changed and understood that he had been connected to President Trump. While Ambassador Sondland's phone was not on a speakerphone, I could hear the president's voice through the earpiece of the phone. The president's voice was very loud and recognizable, and Ambassador Sondland held the phone away from his ear for a period of time, presumably because of the loud volume. So that explains, Wolf, how these people were able to overhear what the president was saying. Now, he goes on to say this. I heard Ambassador Sondland greet the president and explain that he was calling from Kiev. I heard President Trump then clarify Ambassador Sondland was in Ukraine. Ambassador Sondland replied, yes, he was in Ukraine. And he went on to state that President Zelensky, quote, loves your ass. I then heard President Trump ask, so he's going to do the investigation. Ambassador Sondland replied that he's going to do it, adding that President Zelensky will do, quote, anything you ask him to. Even though I did not take notes of these statements, I have a clear recollection that these statements were made. I believe that my colleagues who were sitting at the table also knew that Ambassador Sondland was speaking with the president. So before I go on, I just want to reiterate what he says here. Wolf, he says that I then heard President Trump ask, so he's going to do the investigations, referring, of course, to the investigations that the president had asked for the day before with President Zelensky, the investigations on his political rival. Ambassador Sondland said he's going to do it, adding that President Zelensky will do anything you ask him to. So I'll read a little bit more from this statement that it discusses more about the conversation that the European Union ambassador had with President Trump. The conversation then shifted to Ambassador Sondland's efforts on behalf of the president to assist a rapper who was jailed in Sweden. And I could only hear Ambassador Sondland's side of that part of the conversation. Ambassador Sondland told the president that the rapper was kind of effed here and should have pled guilty. This is referring to another episode. Of course, he recommended that the president will wait until after the sentencing or it will make it worse, adding that the president should let him get sentenced, play the racism card, get him a ticker tape when he comes home. Ambassador Sondland further told the president that Sweden should have released him on your word, but that you can tell the Kardashians you tried. So then he starts talking about towards the end of this phone call. He said after the call ended, Ambassador Sondland remarked that the president was in a bad mood, as Ambassador Sondland stated was often the case early in the morning. And then he says, I then took the opportunity to ask Ambassador Sondland for his candid impression of the president's views on Ukraine. In particular, I asked Ambassador Sondland if it was true that the president did not give an S about Ukraine. Ambassador Sondland agreed that the president did not give an S about Ukraine. I asked, why not? And Ambassador Sondland stated that the president only cares about the, quote, big stuff. I noted that there was big stuff going on in Ukraine, like a war with Russia. And Ambassador Sondland replied that the, quote, big stuff, that benefits the president, like the Biden investigation that Mr. Giuliani was pushing. The conversation moved on to other topics. Very significant there, Wolf. He's saying that the president only cared about the, quote, big stuff, the investigations into the Bidens, and did not care about Ukraine. This corroborates what Bill Taylor testified to earlier this week when he said his aide had overheard that phone call. He's making it clear he heard Gordon Sondland made clear that the president only cared about Ukraine investigating his political rival, Joe Biden. So then it closes with this on this section. It says, upon returning to the embassy, I immediately told the deputy chief of mission and others at the embassy about the call with the president and my conversation with Ambassador Sondland. I also emailed an embassy official in Sweden regarding the issue with the U.S. rapper that was discussed on the call. So July 26th was the last day in the office ahead of a planned vacation. And he talks about how he told Ambassador Sondland about Ambassador Taylor about the July 26th call. And he repeatedly referred to the conversation with Sondland and meetings and conversations that he had thereafter. So then he says at that time, Ambassador Sondland's statement of the president's lack of interest in Ukraine was of particular focus. We understand that in order to secure a meeting between President Trump and President Zelensky, we would have to work hard to find a way to explain Ukraine's importance to President Trump in terms that he found compelling. So here you go, Wolf. This is a person who heard the president of the United States say to the European Union ambassador that Ukraine needed to investigate his main political rival, and that's what he cared about, the, quote, big stuff. He didn't care about Ukraine. He cared about the big stuff, according to what Gordon Sondland told him in the aftermath of this phone call. So very revealing testimony being delivered behind closed doors. This opening statement we obtained that details exactly what David Holmes, this official, is testifying about right now and corroborating this key detail that came out as the Democrats pushed to learn more about the efforts by the president to pursue this investigation into his political rival.
Yeah, this is very, very significant, very dramatic, very important information you're sharing with us, Manu. Thanks very much. Does he say in that opening statement there were others at that table, around the table at that restaurant in Ukraine that may have overheard the conversation on Ambassador Sondland's cell phone?
So we are told from sources, including a congressman who came out of the room and talked to reporters, that there were at least two other people who were aware of this phone call between the president and President Zelensky. Now, it's unclear whether or not the committees will try to pursue to get those interviews with those other individuals. But he also makes clear here, which was interesting, Wolf, that he said that he talked to various people about this in subsequent meetings after that July 26th phone calls. He said he repeatedly referred the call and conversation with Ambassador Sondland in meetings and conversations where the issue of the president's lack interest in Ukraine was potentially relevant. So this came out continually. It was discussed in Kiev among key officials about the president's interest or lack thereof in Ukraine and his real interest, which is pushing for these investigations. So clearly a significant moment here in this investigation that this testimony is ongoing.
What I want you to do, Manu, go back to that key passage in that opening statement by David Holmes, the counselor for political affairs at the U.S. Embassy in Ukraine, who's now testifying under oath before these committees behind closed doors, but we got a copy of his opening statement. I want you to reread for our viewers here in the United States and around the world precisely what he overheard the president of the United States saying to the U.S. ambassador to the EU.
So this is what he said. Exactly, Wolf. He said, I heard Ambassador Sondland greet the president and explain that he was calling from Kiev. I heard President Trump then clarify that Ambassador Sondland was in Ukraine. Ambassador Sondland replied, yes, he was in Ukraine. And he went on to state that President Zelensky, quote, loves your ass. I then heard President Trump ask, so he's going to do the investigation. Ambassador Sondland replied that he's going to do it, adding that President Zelensky will do anything you ask him. That's, quote, anything you ask him to. Even though I did not take notes of these statements, I have a clear recollection that these statements were made. I believe that my colleagues who were sitting at the table also knew Ambassador Sondland was speaking to the president. And then this other passage about the president's ask to investigate Ukraine. I'll read it again. Sondland agreed that the president did not give an S about Ukraine. I asked why not, and Ambassador Sondland stated that the president only cares about, quote, big stuff. I noted that there was big stuff going on in Ukraine, like a war in Russia, and Ambassador Sondland replied that he meant, quote, big stuff that benefits the president, like the Biden investigation that Mr. Giuliani was pushing. And then they talked about other topics. So it's very clear here what the president's interest is, what he was trying to convey to the ambassador to the European Union, that Ukraine needed to launch these investigations into his political rivals at the same time that they were seeking this meeting between the Ukrainian administration and President Trump at the White House, and at the same time as there was discussion about this aid that was later withheld for 55 days, nearly $400 million or so. But it's clear here what the president's interest was. According to this phone call, investigate the Bidens.